I think you feel there's some identification between the United States and France, some similarities between 9/11, for example?
I think huge similarities. First of all, you know, France and the United States are our old friends, probably our oldest friend. And we've been through this before from the days of Lafayette supporting George Washington. We tend to stand together for freedom. And during 9/11, the French were huge supporters of ours. And we want to do the same now. Vice President Biden said we should stand shoulder to shoulder with the French.
The President said that there would be all the help that the French needed would be given to them. Is there going to be intelligence sharing? Is there going to be, I understand, FBI agents maybe brought here?
You know, I can't give details, but we are working very closely together. Before this, we were working closely together. If you ask, you know, our militaries, for instance, there's never been as much sharing and as many joint projects as we've seen over the last couple of years. But I think now we have said to the French, we are there for you. And I think if they need our services, we will be extremely helpful.
On a foreign policy level, what do you think the U.S. should do about this? What should the French reaction be in terms of dealing with the ISIS phenomenon?
You know, President Obama has been very clear on this. We will not give in. This is a fight for freedom. To some extent, this is a fight for all of us. This is a fight for civilization as we know it. And we're going to work with the French, and we're going to work with our coalition partners. And frankly, I hope this is, I don't know if I want to call it a wake-up call, but I think all nations should be looking at this and seeing what they can do, because we have to be in this together. As Obama said, this is a fight against, this was an attack on the French, but it's really an attack on all of us.